working hard at 10 mountain centric cities. We put another hypothesis, working hypothesis, that unusual and repeated compression of umbilical cord might be the cause. How many times, ladies and gentlemen, without witness, without possibility to detect it, in the first 20 weeks of development, baby does grasping of umbilical cord? If you don't believe, you are not convinced, I will show in a second what might be the cause. Ultrasound with recent modalities is very good in following umbilical cord development. You can see here structural and vascular. You can also see that even from the 10-11 weeks of pregnancy, we can study vascularity and morphology of umbilical cord. If we do use 3D power Doppler, beautiful picture of the position of the umbilical cord and false knots of umbilical cord is shown here. So no doubt, ultrasound is quite powerful in study of morphology and vascularity. However, the main advantage is illustrated here. We call this suicide baby, because during period of 1 hour, this particular fetus was grasping its own umbilical cord 10 times. Is there anything beneficial in compressing umbilical cord like this? Now the question is, in the process of the brain development, first 20 weeks of pregnancy are accompanied with the process of hyperplasia. New neurons, specific cells of brain, are formed until 20 weeks. After 20 weeks, it does grow in volume and size by the process of hypertrophy. But all neurons are formed. Any cause, you know, in the first 20 weeks, that cause might reduce number of cells, producing cerebral palsy. So our own hypothesis that compression of umbilical cord might be one of the possible causes. These two persons on the screen should be accredited immediately for being the first to study fetal movements. This is Hans Rudi Preto from my neighboring country, Austria, and this is Amiel Tisson, the best pediatric neurologist from Paris. She's a member of our team and she does very valuable advice. They introduced the study of fetal movements in pregnancy. If you look at this baby here, how many of you are using 3D? Please raise your hand, just for my information. Only first row, thank you. Very good. But even if I ask experts, Uli Giani, Paul Malik here, do you see anything abnormal in this picture? Beautifully normal baby. Normal biometry, age, everything. But baby didn't move. Test was abnormal. Test was abnormal, and again we are speaking about functional, not morphological problem. Normal looking baby doesn't mean that brain function is normal. So the problem is that we know nothing about fetal CNS function. This is a black box in our investigation. It is believed that fetal behavior directly reflects both structural and functional development of CNS. Now, if I ask all of you, what is fetal behavior? I'm sure you all, most of you will have different opinions. It's not easy to define. However, looking in the literature, I found two, at least to me, acceptable definitions. Fetal behavior can be defined as any observable action or reaction to an external stimulus by the fetus, or it is interaction of an organism with its environment. For us sonographers, the best definition, fetal activity is observed or recorded with ultrasonographic equipment and can be spontaneous and stimulating. By the way, this is my granddaughter, antenatally, postnatally, now 10 years of age. These kissing twins have been very popular, and this is my book, sold out, published in London, and the most prestigious journal in our profession is American Journal of Obstetrics and Gynecology, the highest impact 4.5. So editor-in-chief invited us to write review of the fetal phase with 3D and 4D, and this picture appeared on the front page of American Journal, which is very nice for us. Another picture on the front page of American Journal is from our study, collaborative study with Professor Ku in Japan, director of the Donor School there, appeared in the January issue this year on American Journal. Again, multiple pregnancy is now in the great interest of our team. However, face is predictor of the brain. Face is mirror of the brain. Face and brain have the same embryological origin, and they also have the same malformation. Now I'm testing you. Which malformation affects both face and brain? What's your name? You will have my book as a gift. So, face was unexplored area. Now you can see that the face contains a lot of important diagnostic information. In my university city, we did longitudinal study several years ago in 2006, trying to establish normal parameters for the first time. And it was a multidisciplinary team with many specialists involved because the problem is, of great, of wide interest. 100 healthy pregnant women between 7 to 40 weeks, we have been studying 8 fetal movements in first trimester and 14 in the second and third. In the first trimester, we analyzed general movements, tarsal stretching. Again, pictures tell you more than 1,000 words. 11 weeks of pregnancy. Anyone entering this field must know how to read this picture. This is baby at 11 weeks. If you look carefully, you will see the baby has movement of the hands in direction of the face, flexion and extension of lower limbs, rotation. So this is behavior of neurologically healthy baby. If this baby has cerebral palsy, movements will be different. Let's see the same baby 2 weeks later. 13 weeks, you see dramatic increase in the type and frequency of movement. So 13 weeks, you can see general movement, you can see rotation, head and flexion, many others. So even in the first trimester, fetal motoric activity under control of lower center for motoric activity situated in the pons is the subject of our direct investigation. On the face, we studied 6 on the head 3 and hand movement 5. I will now illustrate to all of you, because this is a new field, someone must be attracted, stimulated by these slides. Head retroflexion, 4D picture, easily detected. There is decreased incidence of this particular parameter. Head movement of the hand to head, again, very reproducible, easily detected, and decreased incidence as pregnancy advanced. Hand to mount, also easily detected. But this is very important slide. If you are able in your routine role to visualize 5 fingers and the thumb adapted, this is excellent sign that the baby is neurologically healthy. If, however, this baby has cerebral palsy, thumb will be covered, and you will not visualize thumb. We call it neurological thumb. Very important in our investigation. Decreased incidence, as the pregnancy advanced. Ladies and gentlemen, we used to believe for centuries that the baby doesn't listen, doesn't watch in utero. And we are totally wrong. Noise in utero is as strong as a busy Lahore street. It is 70 decibels, and the baby starts eyelids opening as early as 20 and regularly 26 weeks. So eyelids opening is new neurobehavioral parameter. If you ask me, you are scientific people, what is rate of reproducibility of your technique? Just push another button 3D became 4D, and you see eyelids opening, you see mounting easily. Again, look at the eyes. So if you have any doubt, there is a proof. Peak frequency here is different, is around the end of the second trimester. Mounting normal neurobehavioral parameter, look to the picture, and computer here transfer this picture into the 3D and 4D. That of course much more informative, and we are more reliable with this technique. Yoni. I used to say some joke with this. Even adult physiologists do not know why yawning exists. This is a sign of tiredness, of happiness, of sadness, or whatever. It is unknown. Whatever the reason is, antenatally, we can detect them. You see, yawning, good morning. Okay. Whatever the pathophysiology is behind, this morning I am very happy that no one here exhibiting this behavior. Thank you for listening to me. Good. Peak frequency around the end of second trimester. And if you look at this baby, this naughty boy from Zagreb, look. This boy, tongue explosion, you know, has something which you have, I'm sure, already noticed. He has umbilical cord pulling the neck. Is this the cause or the consequence of tongue explosion? Subject for investigation. There are many reasons to be unhappy in utero. Science knows about 150 diseases affecting fetus. So some of them will detect Janimony with invasive procedure and Mali, and some of them we can detect directly. Maybe in the future we will detect them by the study of phenotype and behavior. Swallowing is important for some gastrointestinal anomalies, but normal neurobehavioral parameter. And again, you see this picture here. Many, many activities which we can now notice can be detected early. Now, opening new field, which will for the next 10 years dominate perinatal congresses, the study of fetal everness, using senses to detect behavior of the baby, to assess so-called cognitive function of the brain. So face is reservoir of so many important diagnostic probabilities. Does the facial expression tell us about fetal brain function? If you don't believe that the baby is smiling in utero, look at this Zagreb boy. Test regards to participants in the Giuliani meeting in Lahore. So the next question is, does the baby cry in utero? This is baby from Dubai. Finally, I mean, all of these spectacular slides came to the conclusion that we should try to detect cerebral palsy antenatally. Here is an example which I showed you. Normal appearance, normal sight, doesn't mean there is no cerebral palsy. It doesn't mean normal fetal brain function. Look at this fixed position. For 1 hour,